All right, I got this UFO solar balloon powered by the sun. It says fill the UFO solar balloon with air, attach line, and watch it magically rise. Well, we're gonna take a look at if this thing actually works or not. We'll give it a go.
Can I do something to help you in some way?
And run, yeah, I guess run.
Or run with you. Okay.
Watch the step.
Alright, go. Oh, that's cool.
Close that up.
You're into that one, I'll tie mine.
So I'm just trying to end of this line.
Yes.
Okay, now the video is playing faster. It's 4 times faster than normal playback rate. And let's take a look at the bag. The bag is black in color. And the color black means that it's absorbing all the sunlight. And the more sunlight that is absorbed by the bag, that means the light is going to be speeding up, heating up those air molecules inside the bag, speeding them up so they get further and further apart, bouncing off the inside walls of the bag. So those molecules of air inside the bag are getting farther apart. That means the density of the air itself inside the bag is decreasing. And it should be less than the density of the air outside the bag. So in theory, just like a hot air balloon rises when you heat up the air inside the hot air balloon, the bag should be rising as well. Now there is the gentlest of breeze pushing around the bag. And so it's hard to see, you know, is the bag rising because of the lesser denser air? Or is it because of the breeze? Now, according to the UFO balloon packaging, the bag should be rising, but it's not quite. Well, maybe it's because there's not enough air inside the bag. You can see it's not totally fully inflated. So maybe that ratio of volume to surface area needs to increase. So we should probably make another attempt at inflating that bag with more air, get it fuller.
Is that enough air?
Yeah.
Wait. You just want me to tie it now?
Yeah, tie it.
Okay, this is the next morning, and according to the directions from the manufacturer suggests that the best conditions is to have it where it's a sunny day, but the temperature is not too high. So you don't want a really, really hot day while doing this. So I try to do this both mornings, and so it's sunny, but the temperature is around maybe in the 60s, or low 70s, so that there could be a bigger temperature difference inside the bag than outside the bag. Now you can see that the bag didn't inflate too well this time. Probably more air could be in there, and as a result, the bag is really not doing too much again. So we need to try it again. Okay, this is the last attempt, the attempt number 3. Each attempt takes quite a bit of time, because inflating the bag is so difficult. But this time we got a fully inflated bag. There is no question about this. It is totally inflated. And yet, it's still not totally working. The only drawback maybe of the conditions maybe not being ideal is that it's a little bit of wispy clouds. So maybe not 100% of the sunshine is getting through to the bag. Maybe it's more like 80-85%. And you can see what's happening to the bag. All right, let's go to a wrap-up. Despite pretty good conditions, we couldn't get the desired results of the bag fully rising. other than the breeze kind of pushing it around. Now, the pros of this item is inexpensive. It might be like $5, $6, $7. It's not that expensive at all. The cons, you need ideal perfect conditions, the sunny days, the sunlight, the temperature. And also another con is it's extremely difficult. I can't emphasize this enough. Extremely difficult to get that thing fully inflated. It took another person to help me out to try to fully inflate that bag. You saw the numerous running back and forth attempts. Boy, was it difficult. But I think I'm going to try another attempt in the near future. I'm not going to totally give up on this bag, this UFO bag. I think it could work. So it's frustrating, but maybe I can get it working at some point. Now, using it in the classroom, I don't think it's totally possible. I didn't use it in my classroom, and based on the such difficulty getting it to work and not getting it to work, I just couldn't use this in my classroom. So I just couldn't do it. So that's it.